LED strips, incredibly useful if you know what you're going to do with them. Chances are though you'll buy some and end up just sticking it to a wall or something, which would be a bit boring, and that's a shame because you can be really quite creative with what you do with them. So in this video we're going to be making three unique lighting projects using, you guessed it, LED strips. Let's get to it. The first project is particularly awesome looking, yet is also incredibly useful, and you'll see why as the design comes together. So the first thing we'll need is a thin sheet of aluminium from which we can cut two long thin lengths. The easiest way to do this is by scoring grooves in the aluminium with a craft knife and then bending them repeatedly until they break free. Once you've got two of them, they can be joined together using a spare piece of aluminium along with some screws and nuts. With that done, we now need to start working on the wiring for the LED strip lights. As we want to be able to adjust their brightness, we need a little dimmer circuit, links to which you can find in the description. This needs to have a power jack soldered to its input terminals and two loose wires soldered to its output terminals, which will be connected to the LEDs later. We're now going to set this into cement, so to prevent cement and moisture from getting to anything on the circuit that's important, we can use some blue tack to shield the power socket solder tabs, and then some electrical tape around the dimmer itself. They can now be mounted inside a little plastic mould of some kind. I used a business card holder. The power socket needs to be securely stuck to the side with some more blue tack so that it will be accessible later. So now it's time to have some fun, as we can mix up some cement and gloop it into the plastic mould, making sure that it surrounds the electronics completely. The aluminium strip can also be inserted, and as you can see, I added some screws to its end to give it more grip so that it won't pull out later once the cement has set. To finish it off, we can plop on a few small pebbles to give it some more interest. The same can be done to the other end of the aluminium, only this time without any electronics, and again we can place a few small pebbles on top for visual effect. Once the cement has set, we can pull the moulds off, and as you can see, we've got some pretty snazzy looking weighted feet. All we need to do now is pop off the blue tack that we used on the power socket, and use some super glue to attach some rubber pads to the bottom to give it some grip. As you can see, it's taking shape and is starting to look very special indeed. I left the protective film in place until this point simply to prevent fingerprints, as having it fingerprint free will allow the LEDs to stick to it more reliably. I'm using a brand of LED strips that has good colour quality and looks like daylight.
Now, just a quick warning about LED strips, and that's don't get cheap ones. Cheap ones tend to get dimmer over time and they have abysmal colour quality. So just spend a little bit extra and get some decent ones. I've discovered these ones recently and they're pretty good. Links in the description, CRI of 90 above, so pretty decent for the price. So again, just avoid cheap ones and get something a little bit better.
Once they're fully stuck down, they can be soldered to the output wires of the dimmer. I used a multimeter to check the polarity, but if you don't have one, just use trial and error and swap them around if the LED doesn't light up. One final touch is to add some finishing oil to the pebbles. This gives them a glossy appearance, as if they're still wet straight from the beach. It looks great. So now a 12 volt power adapter can be connected to the power socket, and the brightness can be adjusted using the dimmer. As you can see, it looks incredibly awesome, almost like something out of Star Trek. But what is it exactly? Well, put simply, it's a work light. As the LED lights surround whatever's underneath them, they illuminate everything with a soft, almost shadowless light that's easy on the eyes, yet provides absolutely fantastic visibility. Pretty useful for homework, tinkering with electronics, sketching drawings, or even sewing.
You get the picture. Excellent visibility from a single power efficient and cool looking device. Not bad. Now, keeping with the modern sci-fi lighting scheme going on here, it's time to work on the next project. For this, we'll need some more pieces of aluminium.
I know, but while I do admittedly like working with aluminium, there is a practical reason for using it so much in these projects, and that's because it wicks heat away from the LED strips mounted to it, increasing their lifespan significantly.
Just as before, I got my pieces from a larger sheet, using the knife and bend technique to trim them down to size. Now we need some lengths of angled aluminium, from which we need to cut off two smaller pieces. These need to then have some holes made through them, which we'll be using to mount them to the aluminium sheet, as well as providing space for two power sockets and an on-off switch. The power sockets can be wired up in parallel, as there are two of them, simply for daisy chaining multiple lights together if desired, and then the on-off switch can be also added to the circuit. I'm using a toggle switch here for a nice tactile feel. We can now use some PCB standoff pillars and accompanying screws to mount them both to the aluminium sheet, one at the top and the other at the bottom. As you can see, I've threaded the power wires through some holes on the front, so we're again ready to add the LEDs. We want two short lengths of these, so cut them down to an appropriate size and solder them together in parallel. Before mounting them, I added some electrical tape underneath at the top and bottom of the aluminium. This shouldn't strictly be necessary, as you may have observed in the previous project, but it is good practice in order to protect against short circuits with the aluminium. Now, technically, this could just be plugged in and the LEDs would light up, but it would look pretty boring, and having a direct, unobstructed view of the LEDs would be very uncomfortable on your eyes, as these strips tend to be very harsh and glaring to look at. This isn't as much of a problem on the Worklight project, because the LEDs face downwards, but this time we need to do something about it. So this is where this project's special trick comes in, for which we'll need two clear A4 acetate sheets. These are super cheap, and you can find some links to them in the description. Now, we're going to use these to diffuse the light, and to make them suitable for this purpose, we need to spend a lot of elbow grease sanding them down on both sides to make them super frosted. It takes quite a while to get them to this point, but it's worth it as it's really effective. We can now fold over the edges of these sheets and glue them to the aluminium like so, with one closer and the other further out to make a gap between them. This sort of doubles up the diffusion effect. Once dried, the light is complete, and it looks significantly more interesting now that the diffusion sheets have been added. There are two holes on the back for mounting it to a wall, so they can be hung up either horizontally or vertically. Now for the grand switch on, again using a 12 volt power adapter. As you can see, the diffusion sheets do a fantastic job at softening the light and making it much easier on the eyes, while making the whole thing look quite modern as well. You can even daisy chain more than one light together, like I mentioned earlier, to provide illumination to an entire room. This is probably one of the more simple projects you can do with LED strips, but it is quite effective.
Right, so now it's time for the third and final project, and this one's pretty unusual, yet it should be very handy for home lighting situations. I'm personally very excited about it. So the first thing we'll need is a piece of aluminium tubing,
and after clamping it in a workbench, we can use a suitable bolt to thread it for mounting later. Now it can be trimmed down to roughly 11 centimeters long, and a hole drilled through the end furthest from the thread we just made. After we've got four of these short rods, we can now get a long length of angled aluminium and drill some holes at each end through which we can mount these rods in place. After making two of these, we now need to get some tin foil and bunch it up to make lots of tiny ridges and crevices, basically making it super uneven. I'm using gloves here so that I don't accidentally make a hole with a fingernail, as it's quite fragile stuff. So now we need to get a large sheet of cardboard, onto which we can use some spray mount glue to attach the foil in place. Try not to press down too hard, as it's important to keep the rough texture that we've given the foil, and we want to avoid smoothing it out. Once the whole card has been covered, you should have something that looks like this, and the two aluminium angles can now be clamped to it on each side using some nuts and bolts. Now we need to get some more lengths of angled aluminium, and as you can see, they need to have two small holes made at each end. Now some LED strip lights can be stuck along the inside like so. Again, I'm using some good quality strips, as the cheaper ones just aren't worth using. Now we can grab some electrical wire and thread it through the holes we made on the rods and also through the holes on the aluminium bars. Once they're pulled tight, we can use some hot glue to hold it all in place. Any excess wire at the top can be trimmed off, but we need to have a length left at the bottom to hook them up to a power source later. Now, to prevent the bars from slipping, add a little bit of hot glue under each of these as well. Now we can expose the conductor on the inside of the wire by carefully trimming off a bit of the insulation and bridge it to the LED strips using a short piece of wire. Each of these long supporting wires will have its own polarity, so one can be soldered to all of the negative pads on the LED strips, and the other can be soldered to all of the positive pads. Once that's done, each of the long wires at the bottom of the light, which we didn't trim down, can be routed to a longer power cord, which can have a power connector added to the other end. Mounting it is just a case of hooking it onto two nails. So you'll probably agree that it doesn't look particularly amazing or anything whilst it's turned off, but don't let that fool you. It's quite special and it solves one of the biggest problems that plague LED strips, which is the glare that they produce. So after hooking it up to a powerful power source, it draws more than the others because a full 5 meter length of strips was used, you can see that it looks actually quite striking now, and the light emitted from it is incredibly soft and diffused, allowing you to comfortably gaze at it directly. This is because the roughed up tin foil scatters the light in many different directions, and as the surface area is very large, it illuminates the room very nicely. This method is more effective at softening the light than the wall light project, and it also requires much less effort for a larger surface area compared to sanding down many pieces of acetate. In fact, the light emitted by this is shockingly close to that of a window, which would be very useful during the short days of winter if you want to keep that summer vibe.
So, there we have it. Three unique but very useful LED lighting projects made out of LED strips. Now, before I sign off, you might be wondering what that thing is on the wall that's been, you know, shown throughout the video. And that was a previous project. It's a RGB crystal tower light. It's pretty cool, and I'll link it down below if you're interested in watching it, because it's a decent one. Right, so other than that, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, don't forget to subscribe and maybe share it with your friends. Other than that, I'm Matt, you've been watching DIY Perks, and I really hope I see you next time. Goodbye for now.
Don't forget that you can find links to the specific LEDs that I used in the description. They're available in different colour temperatures and all have CRI ratings of 90 or above, which I've verified myself with a spectrophotometer. Also, if you'd like to see another LED-related video, then why not check out this one, which is a guide on how to make a super bright, water-cooled LED spotlight. I use this in my studio all the time while I'm filming, so it's again something that's useful in the real world.